BBOR, Black Box Online Radio, coming to you from West Virginia. And the first thing to say, as always, if you like this upload, you can hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed yet, you're welcome to do so. But most importantly, at the end, please drop some comments below so we can continue the discussion. And I just have one announcement to say at first, and that is that we have now assembled our episodes on Robert Graysmith and Zodiac Unmasked into a complete playlist, and that'll be available in the description box. If you haven't heard any of our uploads on Robert Graysmith and Zodiac Unmasked, I would invite you to listen, highly recommend you check it out, and share some things in the comments section, keep the discussions going. It's an 11-part playlist on the book Zodiac Unmasked. Now, to get into today's topic, I did a recent upload about Lawrence Kane a couple of weeks ago. I was planning on composing an upload called Lawrence Kane Timeline to talk about just the events in the life of Lawrence Kane and whether or not that he is connected to the Zodiac Killer mystery or not. We did one for Ross Sullivan on this channel, and I thought it would be a very good idea to do one for Lawrence Kane. But that previous upload just turned into more of a general discussion about Lawrence Kane. And I really thought that I wanted to do this timeline upload to discuss the events in Lawrence Kane's life step by step in chronological order, much like the way we did for Ross Sullivan. But once again, though, I just got caught up reading some of these things that were sent to me, and I think that this is going to go in a little bit of a different direction. We still might do the Lawrence Kane timeline in the future in the pure sense, but I thought it'd be a very good opportunity to talk about Lawrence Kane and some of the events in his life, especially just the overall criminal nature of his endeavors. Now, I have to give a big shout out to the individual who runs the Lawrence Kane WordPress. He posted the URL on my most recent upload about Lawrence Kane. It's a site that I've checked out in the past. I believe his name is Travis. Big thank you to you. But I mean, we've all checked it out at some point. If you get into the Zodiac Killer, sooner or later, you're going to come across the name Lawrence Kane. And in all of the uploads that I've done in the past, I've looked at the Lawrence Kane WordPress from time to time. It's a very well done site. But what I would say is I encountered some things, though, just about the criminal events in the life of Lawrence Kane that were posted here, lawrencekane.wordpress.com. The first thing that I would like to say is this is actually very appropriate that we're putting it out right now. This upload is going up on May 20th of 2020. Lawrence Kane was born on April 29th of 1924, and he passed away on May 20th of 2010. This is actually the 10th anniversary of his death to the day. Pure coincidence, mind you. I was planning on doing this upload about Lawrence Kane, and I came across that 10 years to the day since Lawrence Kane passed away. Lawrence Kane was someone who used many aliases. If you have looked into him as a Zodiac Killer suspect or were just curious about other events in true crime, you'll probably see the interview clip with Harvey Hines, who was talking all about Lawrence Kane as a Zodiac Killer suspect, which relates to a possible solution of the Z13 cipher, which he claims says it, name Kane, 1924. That's what he believes the solution is. So then he found somebody named Kane who was born in 1924 with a criminal record, and that led him down the pathway of looking into Lawrence Kane as a Zodiac Killer suspect. The first thing we need to say is that it's actually written in reverse, of course. I mean, not to sound repetitive or anything if you've heard all this before, but it's like it's written from right to left the way that Hebrew is written from right to left, and that he believed that he was looking for a Jewish person. You know, possibly Arabic is another language that goes from right to left. There are other languages out there. And I was actually told that Tamil can be written from right to left or left to right. There are many languages that go from right to left, but Hebrew was one of them. And Lawrence Kane's birth name was, of course, Lawrence Klein. And he used many different aliases, once again citing the WordPress, Lawrence K, Larry K, Lawrence Barton, Larry King. Yeah, something there. Lawrence Kane as well, spelled with a K. S.A. Kleiman, Lawrence Klein, back to his birth name, Stephen Klein, and Lawrence Kane, spelled C-A-N-E. And I believe in Harvey Hines's interpretation of the Z13 cipher, it could be Kane with a C or Kane with a K. You know, it's like, I mean, once you see, though, how many aliases Lawrence Kane had, it seems like that there's a higher probability that he would have been caught up in anything related to a cipher. And I don't know, in the past, I actually said it was beneficial to Harvey Hines and his theory that Lawrence Kane was not his birth name, that his name was Lawrence Klein, and this all matched up because there's no way that he could have known that Lawrence Kane was Jewish simply by looking at that name. I mean, Kane isn't necessarily a Jewish name, and then he found out his birth name was Lawrence Klein, and it all fits up with Harvey Hines' theory. However, though, once you see how many aliases Lawrence Kane used, I'm really not sure if that is a genuine solution to the Z13 cipher. I mean, many of these things would have come up, though, like King, Klein, K spelled K-A-Y, K spelled K-A-Y-E. All of these are listed here. I would like to just add one point of clarification. Lawrence Kane changed his name to Lawrence K. I mean, like we should say, he was born Lawrence Klein, and he changed his name to Lawrence K. in the 1940s, when he was 17 years old. I believe that was in 1941, according to this site. And I was talking about that once on an upload, and I said something about how he changed it in the 70s. I was like, wait a second, no. I shouldn't say that, because the date that I was confusing was an individual named Robert Smith changed his name in 1976 to Robert Graysmith, and he is the writer that we know as Robert Graysmith with the Zodiac, as well as Zodiac Unmasked, which we have the description. We have our uploads in the description box here, as well as a host of other true crime books. It really amazed me. You put Robert Graysmith into Amazon, so many different books come up. I had no idea he had written so many things, everything about the girl in Alfred Hitchcock's shower to gorillas in the Sierra Nevadas, all kinds of things come up from Robert Graysmith. But I digress from that. I just wanted to say that Lawrence Kane actually changed his name from Lawrence Klein to Lawrence K in the 1940s. Like, so he was 17 years old and he changed his name because he believed that he would have better opportunities finding a job. But to talk about some of the criminal history of Lawrence Kane, in March of 1942, arrested for disorderly conduct in Lakewood, New Jersey. October 18th, 1946, arrested on two counts of battery in Los Angeles, California. September 22nd, 1947, arrested in Hackensack, New Jersey, conspiracy and fraud. August 25th, 1949, using the alias Lawrence K. spelled differently, arrested in Albany, New York for grand larceny. August 26, 1949, Larry K. was arrested in Mineola, New York. Oh, that was his transfer from the previous one. They transferred him from one place to another. And November 28, 1949, Larry K. was arrested in Utica, New York for assault in the third degree and resisting arrest. June 16, 1952, Lawrence K. was arrested in New York City for burglary. May 24th, 1954, using the alias Lawrence Barton, he was arrested in Poughkeepsie, New York for prowling. September 5th, 1959, Larry K. was arrested in Hattiesburg, Mississippi for disturbing the peace, adultery, and assault and battery. September 10th, 1961, Lawrence Kane was arrested in Alameda, California for peeping in windows in California now. December 3rd, 1963, Larry Kane was arrested in Palo Alto, California for shoplifting. September 5th, 1964, Larry Kane was arrested in Oak Brook, Illinois for shoplifting. September 5th, 1964, this is also another charge on that one, also theft in Illinois. March 27th, 1965, Lawrence Kane was arrested in Menlo Park, California for shoplifting. April 26th, 1965, Belmont, California, Lawrence Kane was arrested for prowling. July 11th of 1966, Lawrence Kane was arrested in Miami Beach, Florida for illegal use of a credit card. August 29th, 1968, Lawrence Kane was arrested in Redwood City, California for prowling. February 1st of 1979, Lawrence Kane was arrested in Douglas County, Nevada for obtaining telephone service with attempt to avoid payment and possession of a telephone device. I mean, that sounds like, as I said, avoiding payment. October 1st of 1980, and this is the last one, Larry Kane, spelled C-A-N-E, was arrested in Placerville, California for theft of personal property. And that is the final one on here. And when they're talking about him in that, like, interview segment that we mentioned, they found a man named Kane, born in 1924, or very specifically, used the name Kane. Birth name Lawrence Klein, changed his legal name to Lawrence K. He used the name Lawrence Kane. Many of these here are Lawrence Kane. And one of the things that also helps Harvey Hines' theory, not saying that Lawrence Kane is or was not the Zodiac Killer, 1968, August of 1968, mind you, when he was arrested, he was using the name Lawrence Kane. These arrests in both 66 and 68, he is using the name Lawrence Kane, just throwing that out there. But when they're talking about him, saying they found a man named Kane with a criminal record, absolutely, that's true. This guy was, I mean, he was practically a career criminal. And there are some theories out there that Lawrence Kane was also working as a hitman in both Nevada and Arizona. And I would like to talk more about that in a future upload. I'm pretty sure we're just going to do something separate and standalone on the theories about Lawrence Kane as a hitman. In fact, they say from 1971 to 1974, we had that sort of cease in Zodiac activity, specifically in 71, 72, and 73. They're talking about how the Zodiac ceased to correspond with the police, ceased the taunting. And the people who believe that Lawrence Kane was the Zodiac Killer say that it's because Lawrence Kane moved to Nevada and he was working as a hitman. Now, one of the things that was also described about him, and I'd really have to go back and find the YouTube clip or the article that we were talking about that says this, so I'm just going off of memory on this one, but they were saying that as a hitman, they're saying that Larry Kane would kill anyone. Some people do not kill women. Some people do not kill children. Some serial killers do not kill women and children. I was just on 48 Hours the other day, and I was listening to the story of Israel Keyes, who was a serial killer from Anchorage, Alaska. And he said at one time he tried to kill someone whom I guess was the age of a child. And then he just said that I'm never doing anything to children again. But they said Lawrence Kane was not like that. He would go after anyone. Definitely, though, as we read off his criminal history right here, you can see that this guy heavily involved in illegal activity. But the other thing that stood out to me immediately was he was active in so many parts of the country. And we didn't even really say much about Nevada and nothing about Arizona. So it's like, what we can say, though, about this is that Lawrence Kane is someone who is heavily involved in the true crime world, because it's not so much only about the Zodiac Killer and the mystery of what went on in 1968 and 69 in Vallejo and San Francisco. Once you sort of get under the surface of the Zodiac and you find that all of these suspects genuinely have their own criminal activities, and there is a whole world of just darkness to explore. The big things, though, that I noticed with this is just he doesn't stay in one place for very long. And even when you have the arrests in New Jersey, I mean, we're talking Lakewood and Hackensack, as well as in New York, he was arrested in Albany, New York City, Utica, and Poughkeepsie. So it's like he's moving very frequently. He's really not staying in one place. It's almost nomadic. But the things that I would say about this is that I would highly recommend everybody, once again, check out the Lawrence Kane WordPress, lawrencekane.wordpress.com, because, I mean, I think his name's Travis. He has the newspaper articles positioned in chronological order, and you can hear about some of the arrests in more detail, read about them, rather. But the thing, though, with Lawrence Kane that I really just have to wonder is, with all this criminal nature, I mean, where is some of this in the Zodiac Killer mystery? Because I was quite surprised, as I said, in the Robert Graysmith Zodiac Unmasked discussions, that they even brought up Harvey Hines. And they were saying that Harvey Hines just has tunnel vision. I mean, he had been trying for 20 years to get his suspect, Lawrence Kane, to the crime scenes, which is the appropriate course of action. I mean, we can talk about some of these similarities, but I also have to recall a separate discussion in Zodiac Unmasked when they're just like, well, hey, you know, what about this coincidence? If we add more evidence, then that might be relevant. Until then, maybe it's not. Oh, yeah, but what about this other coincidence? If we had more evidence, that might be relevant, but until we do, maybe it's not. That's just one of the things that you have to look at. I mean, all right, so he's using the name Lawrence Kane in 68 and 69, and then that happens to be Harvey Hines's solution to the Z-13. The big answer is, what were his whereabouts on the I mean, the big question, excuse me, is what were his whereabouts on the nights of Zodiac activity? Can Harvey Hines prove that? And, I mean, he spent 20 years trying to find out specifically what Lawrence Kane was doing. Very good effort, and it's going down the right place, because the answer is not so much, did this person have the personality to commit the Zodiac murders? Half the suspects on the list have the personality of what that could fit the profile of the Zodiac killer. What's more important is, how do you get this person to the crime scenes? How do you get the physical evidence that links them to the Zodiac murders? But even this, though, like, just all of, like, the criminal activities associated with Lawrence Kane, I'm not sure if that helps or hurts him as a Zodiac killer suspect. I would say, though, to the contrary, that if anything, it just really shows that the Zodiac operated for a very short amount of time, and I'm just noticing that Lawrence Kane was moving around very frequently. But, you know, he has passed away now, and that's one of the things, though, that a lot of people are thinking about. There really won't be this type of Golden State killer ending with the Zodiac killer, because almost certainly, within the next 5 to 10 years, if anyone involved with this was still alive, and I say anyone because we could still entertain the group murder theory, as well as some other things like, you know, the Zodiac hoax theory is a variant of the group murder theory, and multiple perpetrators, multiple assailants, and I say assailants because even if one person committed the murders, then someone else could have been involved with the letter writing. And almost certainly, it seems like maybe someone else could have been involved with the phone calls and evidence tampering, all of these things. When I'm on the Zodiac WordPress right now, and just note some things. Lawrence Kane had 2 siblings, but both of them did not survive infancy. One of them even has a death certificate that is listed as age 0 on my birthday, of all things, which is also in the month of May. But when it comes to Lawrence Kane, though, we do have some things about his military record. He was in the Naval Reserve from a time, and that, once again, he's also an ex-mental patient. With Lawrence Kane, though, there's a whole web of darkness that is associated with this guy. But once again, these things happen so frequently in the Zodiac Killer mystery. I would say, though, that we're probably going to have to just leave it there for now, and maybe somebody will uncover some hard piece of evidence that will either incriminate or exonerate Lawrence Kane in the Zodiac mystery. Once again, if you find something that exonerates him, I think that would be equally excellent. But once you just hear, like, about how large his web of criminality was, I mean, there's a story in there in itself, and we're going to look at this in the future, and I would hopefully perhaps even correspond with some people who have looked into Lawrence Kane a little bit more. What were his activities as a hitman, and how credible are these accusations, and we can see where it goes from there. So that's where we're going to have to leave it for now, but please, tell me, what do you think about Lawrence Kane? What do you think about his criminal behavior and all of that? Do you think that that is something that is going to be kind of incriminating him in the Zodiac Killer mystery, or do you think that is something that is pushing towards exoneration? I mean, what I can say is that on the surface, he seems very, very guilty as someone who would do something like the Zodiac Killer mystery, someone who is somewhat intelligent, but he has mental instability, and he is definitely, definitely a criminal by all means. Huge criminal history that we read off there, and it's all over the country. But I would definitely like to look into this a little bit more. So I think that's where we're going to have to leave it for now. This is the 10th anniversary of the death of Lawrence Kane. Please drop anything you would like in the comments section below, and you can follow us on Instagram, BlackBoxNed88. One more time, BlackBoxNed88 on Instagram. I will see you guys there for the bonus podcast, and until next time.